Yeah, we on top, though we on the bottom. Oppressed every day, might not see tomorrow. Curses on us, cause we broke our laws. Now we in a land we don't call our own.
We been oppressed so long.
Oh, yeah.
But one day we gon' rise up. These nations, they don't want no problem.
But they got one.
Cause one day you'll come back, 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 back. Cause one day
you'll come back.
And I know this will be safe.
We are Israel United in Christ, and we come out here to teach you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Native Americans who we are according to the Bible.
Bring it out.
We're going to show you that slavery was in the Bible, and slavery was Bible prophecy. Read what you got, huh?
The book of Isaiah, chapter 58 and verse 1. Cry aloud.
The scriptures tell us to come out here and cry aloud. That's why we talking loud. Read.
Spare not.
It says spare not. We don't care how you feel. Read.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
It says come out here to lift our voice up like a trumpet. Then we gonna speak loud into this microphone to wake our people up. Read.
Right.
And show my people their transgression.
We gonna show God's people, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, your transgressions, what you doing wrong.
Get out. Get out.
And the house of Jacob, their sins.
We gonna show you what your sin is. What is sin according to the Bible? Let's show our people what sin is.
Bring it up.
Because you go to church on Sunday, they don't tell you what sin is according to the Bible. So we gonna bring it out what sin is.
The book of 1 John chapter 3 and verse 4. Whosoever committed sin transgresses also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
So sin is the breaking of God's law. So what we come out here to do is show you what sin, what laws you are breaking.
That's right.
We're going to show you what sins you are breaking. We are trying to bring you back into the body of Christ.
Right.
Yeah.
Sin is the breaking of God's laws. Read.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
The Bible said, know ye not that ye are the temple of God. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
It said that the Spirit of God is dwelling in you.
And if any man defile the temple of God,
it said if you defile the temple of God, how do you defile the temple of God? By eating unclean foods, by smoking. If you are smoking cigarettes, smoking blunts, smoking cigars, black in the mouth, you are defiling the temple of God.
That's right.
For the temple of God is holy.
Yo, the temple of God is holy, meaning it's separate. Read that one more time.
For the temple of God is holy.
Oh,
verse 17. If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are.
So God said he's going to destroy your temple if you continue to smoke. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 61.
Bring it out, Art.
How will he destroy your temple? You already know the cigarette bad for you. On the side of every... On the side of every card, on the side of every package, says okay. But what make you smoke that cigarette? Read this. This is what's going to happen if you keep smoking cigarettes.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
So if you keep smoking cigarettes, he said every sickness and every plague which is not reading his Bible, he gonna bring upon you. What? Lung cancer. He gonna bring that upon you. Diabetes. Heart disease. He gonna bring that upon you if you don't stop smoking cigarettes.
Bring it out!
Bring it out! Give me 1 Peter 2 and 21.
Read the book of 1 Peter. Chapter 2 and verse 21.
We're trying to show you what sin is. Alright? Smoking is a sin. Now we're going to go into some more. Read.
For even hereunto were ye called, because Christ also suffered. for us, leaving us an example that ye should follow his steps.
So Christ left us an example to follow his steps. Not nobody else's steps, but his steps.
That's right.
Give me Jeremiah. Give me Jeremiah. Christ said to follow his steps. Now somebody show me in the Bible what Christ, Jesus the Christ, celebrated his own birthday party and bought themselves gifts. How you gonna bring somebody, how did Jesus Christ bring himself gifts? Show me in the Bible what Jesus Christ celebrated his own birthday. Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speak unto you, O house of Israel. Thus says the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen.
So the Most High God told us to learn not the way of the heathen. The heathen are the other nations. The heathen are the other nations. Read.
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Don't be dismayed at the sign of heaven. Talking about astrology. Don't worry about your horoscopes and all that mess. Read.
For the heathen are dismayed at them.
Yeah, because they fascinated with that stuff. Read.
For the customs of the people are vain.
It said, for the customs of those heathen, those people are vain, meaning they lie. It's productive.
Bring it up.
The horn out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen, with the axe.
It said, somebody gonna go cut a tree out of the forest. The workmen of the man with an axe. Read.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
They deck it with what?
With silver and with gold.
What custom is this talking about? It's talking about your slave master.
Bring it up. What?
I want to know if y'all celebrate Christmas when you was enslaved. When you was a slave, what you celebrate Christmas?
Bring it up.
What you bringing gifts? You want a gift.
Yes,
you want a gift during slavery. Master Charles will give you away and sell you to give you away to somebody in Mississippi for a gift. If you want to celebrate Christmas, it is against God. It's time for us to teach our kids something new. Read.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
Did y'all know the Christmas tree was in the Bible? How you doing, young man? Come over here and let us talk to you for a second. We are giving you the greatest knowledge on the earth right now. Don't walk past this knowledge. A lot of people ran by and they want the Bible. So you coming over here. There's something special about you.
Get up.
There's something special about you. First question I must ask you on this sound right here, all right? It's the 12 tribes of Israel. You ever heard of the 12 tribes of Israel?
Yes.
Okay, that's God's chosen people. Do you see your father's nationality on this side? On this side is going to be the side of the slave master. That's the name he gave us. On this side is what you're going to find in the Bible.
You see yourself on this side?
Do I see myself on there?
What is your nationality, may I ask you?
Black, white, and Mexican.
Black, white, what is the nationality of your father, you mean?
Black and Mexican.
You what?
Black, white, and Mexican.
Okay, what?
Black and Mexican.
Your dad is black and Mexican. Do you know what your grandfather was? You have to be one of them to be black and Mexican.
I think he's black.
You think he's black?
Yeah.
Okay, if he's black, you're from the tribe of Judah. This is what you got to figure out. If you want to find yourself in this world, in this place called America, this is what you got to do. Listen.
The book of Job, chapter 8 and verse 8. For inquire, I pray thee, of the form of age, and prepare thyself to the search of their fathers.
You got to prepare yourself for the search of your fathers. Because you know Babylon the Great, America's going to be destroyed. All right? You got to prepare yourself for who you are. Okay? If you are God's chosen people, salvation is for you. Did you know America's going to be destroyed with thermonuclear fight? Did you know that? We don't know when, but it's going to go down, right? All right, what you got, give me good one. Yeah, because if you are the children of Israel, this is what God said about you, this.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
You are holy, you are separate among all the other people that's walking on the planet Earth. You are separate from the white man. You are separate from the Japanese, the Chinese, the African.
That's
you see
right.
What I'm saying? If you are so-called black, Hispanic, and the Native American, you are the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's
what God said about you. Read it again.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
You holy, read.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
God chose you to be special. That's why out of all the people you walked over here, he chose you to be special. Read.
above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
He said above all people. What we living to try to do, be what? Equal to. We try to be equal to the white man, but God already created you to be above all people that's on the planet Earth. Do you believe that? Okay. All right, so God requires something. Give me, yeah. Let me show you some stuff. Let me show you how to be above all people.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God.
You got to learn how to fear God first. Our people, we don't know how to fear God. We don't even believe in God. We don't believe God will jack us up. Read.
Bring it up.
To walk in all his ways and to love him and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
So you got to learn how to serve God. Yeah, we do this every weekend. We come out here and wake our people up, man. Hold on, I got some more stuff for you. Hold on. Alright, you from Houston?
Hey, we got here. I'm from here, but I live in Houston.
Okay, we got schools in Houston. We got schools in Houston, Texas, Dallas, Texas, Austin, Texas, Austin, Texas. Alright? Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head.
So the Bible said that the Israelite man, the people on this side, we're not supposed to make baldness upon our head. Meaning to get a razor and put it on our head, all right?
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
You can't shave off the corners of your beard. You see all those men up here, we got beards on our face. If you can grow a beard, you're supposed to let your beard grow. Your beard gonna show that you went from boyhood to a man, all right?
Look it up.
So you gotta have a beard on your face, like a lion. You gotta look like a lion out here. But if you can't grow one, you know, hey, it is what it is, read.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
Nor do what?
Make any cuttings in their flesh.
You can't make any cuttings in your flesh. All them tattoos you got, that's a sin according to the Most High God.
That's right.
You can't do that. God made you holy. He already made you perfect. He made you in his image.
Right.
And for you to take his image and draw on it, thinking it's cool, you know what I'm saying? That's against God. Give me Habakkuk chapter 2.
We're
showing our people our transgressions. This is what's going to change. Yeah. If you change, guess how many lives you can change?
I do this.
You know what I'm saying? So you got to change it with the words of God. So that's why the Most High God, he knows it's in your heart. That's why you over here. So you got to understand this right here. Read.
Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 18. What profit the graven image?
It said, what profit the graven image? Do you know what the graven image is? What's the graven image? It's like an idol. What profit the idol, right?
That the maker thereof hath given it.
All right, do you know you got an idol on your neck right now? You got a bunch of idols. Tattoos your idol. You your own idol? Well, I'm talking about that cross on your neck right now, all right? It said, read that again.
What profit the graven image?
It said, what profit is that cross gonna do to you? Read.
That the maker thereof hath graven it.
Also, somebody had to take that cross and put it in a mold and pour gold in it or whatever and made it. What profit did that to you? Read.
The molten image and a teacher of lies.
Whoever made that image for you to put on and wear is a teacher of what?
Teacher of lies.
They are teachers of lies. Because our people wear cross to feel safe. They feel like God is with us at all times when you got the cross on your neck. You know that cross is just represent what Christ was crucified on?
Yes, bring it up.
Somebody gets shot with a gun. Say your cousin gets shot with a gun or something. And you walk around with an AK-47 on your neck. That don't even make sense. Because that's what he got shot with. See, that's the same thing they used to crucify our Lord and Savior on. And now they have taught our people to walk around with it on their neck. What? You see what I'm saying? They have taught our people to get it tattooed on their body. But it's a teacher of what?
Teacher of lies.
That's a teacher of lies, bro. There's nowhere in the Bible it says put a cross around your neck. It's gonna represent the body of Christ. You see what I'm saying? So if you love God, you know what you mean to love God. Let me finish it up right there.
That the maker of his work trusted therein to make dumb idols.
To make what?
Dumb idol.
So a cross around your neck, that's a dumb idol according to the Bible. Alright?
Get out.
That's a dumb idol. Alright? Give me all what love is. You say you love God. Let me see if you love God or that idol on your neck. And we're gonna see right now.
I feel like I only need my own personal relationship with him.
You need your own personal. We're gonna show you how to get an own. See, we're going about how the Bible feels.
Bring it out, up.
Watch this.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3. Huh? For this is the love of God.
Oh, this is how you, this is the love of God right here, read.
That we keep his commandments.
That we keep his commandments. Read.
And his commandments are not grievous.
It said the commandments not grievous, meaning they're not hard to do. Give me the commandments are not hard to do. So do you love God to keep his commandments? So if God tells you to do something, where are the words of God? What does Bible call? The word of what? The word of God. So if God gonna speak to you, where he gonna speak to you at? In his Bible, right? So if God tells you to do something, and you say you love God, and you don't do it, what that mean? You don't love God, right? So watch this.
Bring it up.
The book of 1 John, chapter 2, and verse 4. He that said, I know him, and keep it not his commandments.
It said if you know him, and you don't keep God's commandments, read.
Is a liar.
Is a what?
Is a liar.
The Bible calling you a liar right now. God calling you a liar. Huh? You're not perfect. You
mean, bring it out, up.
You're not perfect. All right, watch this. Do you believe who's the perfect people in the Bible? You know the perfect people?
There's only one.
There's only one? Are you sure about that?
I think so.
I guess. See, that's what we were taught. But watch this right here.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5 and verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
Read that again. Pay attention. You said you're not perfect, but can you be perfect? Watch this. This is what Christ said. Watch this.
Matthew chapter 5 and verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
Do you know what it means to be perfect, first of all? Let me show you what it means to be perfect. Because you can be perfect, young man.
I got some more stuff that I have. Y'all can talk about it. We can talk about it. Uh-huh. I got, like, everybody has their own opinion on this. So I'll probably talk to you about what you just talked about right this second, because I don't feel like anything is perfect.
Okay, what the Bible just said?
No, I understand that. Like I said, we'll talk on this. You understand this better than me, because that's how I feel. But I got to go right now.
All right, we got all our information on that paper right there.
Okay.
All right?
All right, y'all.
Read this. Listen to this as you walk out.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 55 and verse 8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts.
The Bible said that God said his thoughts ain't your thoughts. Read.
Neither are your ways my ways.
Neither are your ways God's ways. You understand that? Give me Ecclesiastes 3 and verse 24. We want to do. We want to go on our own ways and our own thoughts. We don't want to do what the Bible say do. When we come out to show our people what the Bible say, they run off. Now all of a sudden they got something to do. Alright? Read that.
Zechariah chapter 3 and verse 24. For many are deceived by their own vain opinion.
They say for many people gonna be are deceived for their own vain opinion. He don't want to do what the Bible say. He want to say, I don't think no one can be perfect.
Hello.
But God said what?
Angelo.
Read.
And this evil suspicion has overthrown their judgment.
This evil suspicion has overthrown his judgment. He want to keep getting tattoos all on his eyelids. He want to get tattoos all on the bottom of his feet.
Hey, man. Hypocrites on the planet Earth. Give me Proverbs 11 and 9. God said he gonna break the pride of your power. It ain't no black power in y'all community.
Right.
And black lives don't matter to you niggas either. Because you niggas kill each other more than a damn police shoot you down.
Hey,
who got that thank you letter the KKK wrote to niggas? I'm calling you niggas now because a lot of y'all don't want to repent. Who got the thank you letter the KKK wrote to the damn black man? Damn, y'all to wake up. KKK write you a thank you letter and say, hey, y'all doing a beautiful job destroying each other, gang banging and selling crack to your own damn people. He said y'all doing great. He said y'all doing absolutely fine.
Bring it
up. I said I love you and I commend you and got your ass to KKK. Read what you got.
Proverbs chapter 11 and verse 9.
Come out some black lives matter. Y'all is a damn lie. Read.
And hypocrite.
Y'all said a what?
And hypocrite.
A what?
And hypocrite with his mouth destroyed his name.
God said a hypocrite with his mouth destroyed his name. Now what we out here doing, we out here telling you the truth according to the Bible. You are Israelites, the Bible speaks of. We are God's chosen people. You need to repent and come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. We God's chosen people. Listen to this KK, listen to this letter the KKK wrote to y'all. The KK said, the Ku Klux Klan would like to take its time to salute and congratulate all gangbangers for the slaughter of over 4,000 black people since 1975. Now we know the lies, we know it's higher than that. Hold on, the Ku Klux Klan would like to take this time to salute and congratulate all gangbangers for the slaughter of over 4,000 black people since 1975. You are doing a marvelous job. Keep killing each other for nothing. The streets are still not yours, nigger. It is ours. Yeah, there was a group of playing one for y'all. You are killing each other for our property. You are killing what could be future black doctors, lawyers, and businessmen that we won't have to compete with. And the good thing about it is that you are killing your youth. So we won't have to worry about niggers in generation to come. This, I ain't gonna even read all this. This what the Ku Klux Klan wrote to y'all. Time for y'all to wake the hell up and repent, man. We God's chosen people.
That's right.
For real, don't get tired of seeing the destruction of my people, man. I'm tired of this. Give me a root folk.
Bring it up.
Tired of this, man. Time for us to wake up, man. You are the Israelites, the Bible speaks of. You are God's chosen people. Slavery in the Bible, slavery in the Bible prophets. It's time to wake up. Time for us to wake up. Destruction is coming to this place.
That's right.
Y'all been seeing all the stuff that's going on the news? Have you been seeing all the stuff that's going on? ISIS been getting everybody. You got ISIS right here in your community selling your ass candy and chips and cakes. Y'all gonna start laughing at them and letting them play with, fuck with your women. They banging your baby mama. Your grandmama come down here to the store for a damn drink. They flirt with your baby mamas, banging them up and sending them back home to you. Read what you got. 4:13.
The book of Baruch, chapter 4, verse 13. They knew not his statutes.
But God said our people don't know his statutes. That's what we out here to do now, to show you his statutes, to show you his laws, Lee.
Nor walk in the ways of his commandments.
Y'all don't walk in the ways of God's commandments. Read.
Nor trod in the path of discipline in his righteousness.
The path of discipline in his righteousness is his commandments. Give me Jeremiah 4:22. Then we put the white man poison in our body. We pop his pills. We smoking cigarettes. We drink, we get drunk. You can drink liquor, but you can't get drunk. That ain't his right there. He didn't create that. Read what you got. You snort his cocaine. You smoke his crack. Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 4, verse 22. For my people is foolish.
God said, my people is foolish. He only talking about one nation of people. He said, my people. He talking about two Israelites, you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. He said, my people is foolish. Read.
They have not known me.
Y'all don't know. I wish somebody would say they know God. You a damn nice. You know the devil. You know the devil. You don't know this God right here. Because you knew this God, you know this God only love you and only you. He don't give a damn about the Arabs. He don't give a damn about the Chinese. He don't care about the white man or the African. If you knew this God, read.
They are sodomous children.
The Most High said y'all sodomous children, read.
They are not understanding.
He said y'all don't got no understanding. You don't got no understanding of this Bible. Y'all don't know the God, just like you got these Arabs talking about they know God. Talking about they worship the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Y'all a damn lie.
Bring it up.
These people sit up here and take a rock and throw rocks at a rock. These people have to make a hard cement and throw a damn rock at the rock. Talking about you casting away your sins. Man, look, sit your ass down somewhere. Throwing
bring
rocks
it up.
At a rock. There's only one God. That's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Yeah, right.
And he's the God of the Israelites, and he ain't dealing with nobody else.
That's right.
Read that again. Finish that up real quick.
They are wise to do evil, but to do good, they have no knowledge.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.